In the wake of the brutal Sri Lankan civil war, one coconut oil co-op hopes that the fair trade ethic will help the country get back on its feet again. Robin Bell has this report.
Our main buyer, the Dr. Bronner's, mandated that we need to be organic and fair trade. For the workers, it means that they are assured market rate or above minimum wages. They are assured better working conditions. They are assured better employment conditions. And in other words, that all the stakeholders within the value chain is not exploited.
Before it became a codified set of regulations, the organic movement also embraced the social side of sustainability, fair wages for farm workers and fair pricing for farmers. But with the onset of organic regulations, that side of sustainability was completely shut out. And the result is that there is no guarantee that when you purchase an organic food or organic personal care item, there's no guarantee that there is actual fair labor conditions on that farm.
We built this coconut oil factory in Sri Lanka because Dr. Bronner's needed a source of certified organic and fair trade coconut oil. We felt that Sri Lanka was the most suitable place for our project because with its coconut triangle, it's one of the relevant and very well developed producers of coconut in the world. The conversion of the coconut production and the processing according to organic and fair trade standards we considered very feasible. And so in 2005, we started on the journey of putting in the world's first certified organic and fair trade coconut oil production. Today is the second anniversary of our startup of production. 2 years ago, the first time the presses, two of the presses in the press room, started screaming, and this is when the oil started flowing.
The first step in the coconut oil production process is the delivery of the nuts to the factory. The delivered coconuts are piled up in the factory and then cure or mature in piles for 3 to 5 weeks. Once they're mature, the nuts are husked. Within 48 hours after husking, the nuts need to be processed in the wet section. The first step there is the hatcheting. Depending on whether the nuts are used for food grade or cosmetics grade oil, the parings, that's the brown skin covering the coconut kernel, is either removed or left on. The ground up coconut kernel that contains about 50% water then goes into an air heated dryer where the moisture content is reduced to less than 2%. The dried coconut kernel is transported into storage silos, trickles down by gravity into expeller presses, and there the oil is separated from the seed cake. The crude oil is filtered in one of several plate filter presses and then put into storage tanks. Finally, we pump the cosmetics grade oil into large 6,000 gallon flexi tanks and ship them by the container loads to the United States.
What fair trade certification guarantees in any environment is that the company or the purchaser is socially responsible, which means that at least the legal minimum wages are paid, and in most fair trade factories there is a lot of emphasis on health and safety, and also in some cases going above what is legally required in terms of wages and other benefits.
The production of coconut oil is eco-friendly in that all of its byproducts have beneficial uses. The coconut husks are sold to fiber mills that turn it into robes and carpets, and the seed cake is sold for animal feed and in the future for human nutrition.
About 30% of the coconut shells are burned in a boiler that generates steam for the dryer and for hot water. That way, we don't have to use petroleum oils and can use our own fuel.
The benefit must go to the community, not to the equal person. We have done a lot of things to develop the community in this area, especially we are in northwestern province of Sri Lanka. In this area, we have done a lot of things for the community. But in two sectors, we mainly concern education sector and the health sector. Because if you help for the education, it will not help for the present generation. It's generation to generation, it get the benefits. Same time, if you give some equipments to the health sector, say for the hospitals, that also will get the benefit for future generations also.
Dans mon coin pas connu qui pour faire mon prendre la guitare pour faire un voyage bien loin. Mon ferme, mon lisier, mon laisse, mon lame, tripoter, mon laisse, mon esprit. Allez, mon écoute, mon lait qui a batté. Soudain, mon lipier commence taper, un bel nissa commence trapper. Triste dans mon coin pas connu qui pour faire mon prendre la guitare pour faire un voyage bien loin. Mon ferme, mon lisier, mon laisse, mon lame, tripoter, mon laisse, mon esprit. Allez, mon écoute, mon lait qui a batté. Soudain, mon lipier commence taper.